Alright, so what I have here is the new Cyborg S.T.R.I.K.E 7 gaming keyboard from Mad Catz, and it's actually a pretty decent keyboard, especially for the price. You would expect a lot of performance out of this thing, and I think the reason for the price is mainly for this device up here, which is the screen itself. I'm sure that by itself is a couple hundred bucks. The keyboard itself is very nice. There are a few things that I am probably going to have to make some modifications to. I'll probably talk about that a little bit later. But let's go about some of the negatives of this keyboard first, because I know that I want to get that out of the way. One of the big negatives is I'm not a fan. Well, this is actually a personal negative. I just don't like large size keys, tall keys. The reason why is because they're tiered. So let's see if I can get my camera to focus here. The reason why I don't like the high-end keys is because they're tiered. So this key is larger than this key. This key is larger than that key. So it's easier to go down when I'm sliding my fingers around to try to hit actual commands. But if I want to go up on the commands, my finger is going to be hitting the key itself. So that's not really good when you're trying to, like, say, I need to reload real fast, or I need to grab an item real quick. This is going to bother me, and that's going to stop. But that, unfortunately, I cannot make any modifications to. The one thing I am going to try to do is the lighting of this thing. This thing is god-awful lighting. I don't know why gaming keyboards have to do this type of lighting system. Why can't it be just the keys by themselves? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little DIY project and try to blacken out all these lines, all these lights, and have just the letters light up by itself. But that'll be another video later on down the road. So for the keyboard itself, we have your basic keys. We have all these, which are back rowed. You can change any of those. And on the keyboard, you can change any of the C's here. So any of those C's can be changed to whatever you want as well. You can also macro the numpad once it's detached. So you can detach this, have it by itself, put the screen onto the numpad, and then you can have all these keys to be macroed. So you can use that for a quick thing, which is kind of like what I have here. This is my the other hand device that I have here. This one I just use for a lot of my MMO games. So this kind of, or this I should say, is what's replacing this. But I still love this just because of the layout, so I'm probably not going to get rid of that. I'm probably still going to keep that. This will just be used as my standard numpad and arrow keys and whatnot. So that's pretty much it for the keyboard itself. Negative is the lighting system and the tall keys. Not a fan of the tall keys. I prefer the mid-range keys myself. But those are the only two negatives I really see about this keyboard. So let's go with the positives. The positive is this matte finish. I love this matte finish. I hate gloss. I don't know why a lot of, especially like Razer products, everything's gloss. It just looks disgusting over time, and you just see all that sweat and all that sticky. It's just gross. No thank you. The other big thing is this screen. This screen is probably the coolest thing about the keyboard itself. So let's spend some time here going over this this brain of the keyboard. We have the mute button here for your speakers. We have the mute button here for your microphone, volume rocker. This is a back button. And this is nothing. This is just a light to showcase the logo. You can't really change it. It does change colors, though, to let you know which mode you're in, but you can't change the icon of it or whatever you want, which is weird because I saw online another keyboard that had the Mad Catz logo there, but I'm sure it's a special logo. I'm sure what you can do is you can probably pop this off, which I'll try probably later on, and customize your own logo and put your own logo on there, because I'm sure this is just a giant thing that's lit and you can put your own stuff, whatever. So we'll probably get into that during my DIY project. Alright, so let's go over the brains of this thing. So this is a touchscreen. Let me get a little bit closer here, see if I can focus. So this is the touchscreen of the device, and it's not a, I don't know what the word is, but it's not touched by your skin of your fingers, but it's actually pressure sensitive. So it's a pressure sensitive touchscreen. And it's got a couple apps here. I'm sure they may or may not add more. It'd be nice if they added some more here that we can kind of customize this to do a few other things. But what we have here is the app launcher, so I can put all my apps in here that I want to quickly launch, like Photoshop, or if I want to launch a game real quick, I can do it all right there. This is your typical music stuff, music player. We have volume here for all my volume. The lighting system here, you can change the lighting of the keyboard. We have a clock here, basic clock. There's two different clocks. You can have a digital clock, or you can have the normal clock. We have a stopwatch here. And then we have cooldown timers, which is kind of cool. I've actually been using a few of them to let me know when my hot pockets are done, so I can quickly go to the microwave and eat my food. But to be serious, the cooldown stuff is actually for MMOs and just basically MMOs and like StarCraft, I guess you could say. This cooldown timers let you know when you can activate that command again. The Windows lock key, nothing special about that. Just disables the window key. It's about it for those that don't know. Then we have language here. We can also adjust the settings of when I want this screen to shut off. I can actually adjust the time as well. So I can do an example like during the day I could have it not be lit up, and then at night I could have it slowly adjust level of light. It's kind of complicated to explain, but that's pretty much what it is. It's kind of like the auto brightness on your phone, essentially. And then notes here, which is kind of cool. I could leave myself a note if I'm leaving to get my hot pocket here. I could say, don't touch my fucking keyboard, or leave a message or anything for those that want to read it. So that's pretty cool. And then we have TeamSpeak. This allows me to see who is on and who is talking, so that way I don't have to, when my game is in full screen, I don't have to alt-tab to see who is talking to me. Unless you're doing three-screen stuff, then it doesn't really matter, but that really depends on your setup. So that's basically it for the keyboard. I really do kind of love it. There is some modifications I will be making to it. We'll probably talk a little bit more about that in another video. But before we close, let's take a look at some of the other attachments that come onto this. We have another wrist attachment, which goes here. And then we have your basic one, which goes here. And then we have another one, which is for your wrist. So this one has a couple buttons on here. We have a scroll wheel, and then we have kind of like the sniper button, essentially, which is the same thing on the rat. You find on the rat mice as well. And then you can adjust these in and out as far as you want, or as far in as you want to. Alright, so let's go over the software real quick so you can check out some of the cool stuff that the screen can do. Alright, so here's a program for the Strike 7. If we go into programming here, this is going to lead me to the programming area, so I can do all my macro settings here for each individual thing. The main thing, though, is probably this screen here, so I can sit here, and when I go into my profile mode, I can edit all of these icons here. I actually have a message board that I'm going to be creating to kind of create a little community area for this keyboard, so I'm going to be making custom icons for certain games. The ones I'm going to be starting off with right now are going to be one of the MMOs I'm playing, which is Terra, and I'll be doing some for StarCraft as well. So that way you guys have some profiles for that. But let me show you what goes on here. So we click here and we add a command. All right, so once we add the command, once we add commands for all of these, then we can go here to edit commands, and we can put visual references for what those are going to be on the keyboard itself. So once you can create your own, when you go to the message boards that I created, I'll show you the height and width for these icons, as well as Photoshop templates, so that way you guys can edit your own and kind of create your own as well, and kind of submit it to the community if you'd like. But the max size is going to be 80 times 80, so that's what you're going to want to do for all these icons. If you do anything larger than that, like let's say I want to do a 1024 times whatever image, it's only going to take what's in the center of that image. It won't be the entire image itself. I've done 100 times 100, and it compresses it back down to 80 by 80, so, and it looks really pixelated, but the screen itself is actually is pretty good. It has some pretty high pixels on it for the $300 price tag. So let's go see here, what else is there? So we'll edit commands, those will be there, and then once we hit save, and then we go back to edit commands, and we click on activate profile. Once we go to our, let's see if I can focus here, this icon down here, which is what I skipped, this one goes into the icon sets, and all my icons are set for my games. So that way, when I press them, the actual command will do its thing. But the weird thing is that when I press it, it kind of gives me this little darkened animation, right? It'd be cool if it was a little bit of a different animation, like something that comes out or makes a noise or something, but it doesn't do anything, but whatever, it doesn't really matter. When you're playing a game real quick, you don't need to see it real fast. You just want to press it and have it do its action. So that's it. So that's how you edit commands on the visual parts of the keyboard. Like I said before, on the message boards, I'll be creating some more for you guys to download as well. The other thing to note is that I'm also going to be creating stickers for the keyboard as well. So that way, whatever commands that you see here, we'll actually be creating some stickers. So that way you can put them over your keyboard. Kind of like how I have it here with my Sony Vegas editing keyboard. I have some stickers here that kind of let me know what commands do what. I'll probably do the same thing for the games as well. So that way when I'm designing some for the keyboard, for the keyboard touchscreen, I'll have some for you guys as well. For those that don't have a screen, you guys can take a look at some of the keyboard stickers too, which are kind of cool. And then we have the launcher here. This is where all the app launchers are going to be. So let's say if I'm going to click in here, and I'm just going to put all my Adobe products for programs. Let's just put a few in here, some repeats. All right, we click apply. And then when we go to the screen, and we go to the app launcher, so we'll hit the back button, and then we'll go over here to app launcher. Now all my icons. So if I were to do Photoshop, for example, here. Let's see if I can press it here. It should boot up Photoshop. Yep. All right, and that's pretty much it for the program. Like I said before, I'll have something to where you guys can edit your own commands. Let's actually go back to the programmer real fast. And let's go to edit icons here. So to make your own, we'll have to remove it, click on it, import an image, find it wherever it is on your keyboard. It does allow JPEG and PNG. I'm not sure about the other ones yet. I haven't tested those out. But that's good for PNG because then you can make see-through backgrounds. So if I want whatever background this is on the menu here, I can't change. That has to stay like that. So I got to have this techno logic whatever thing in the background that stays. I wish I could change that, but that stays the way it is. If in the future I can change what that image is, that'd be sick. Now we can start doing theming for a lot of our icons here. One thing I am going to test out is see if there's a way we can, as far as theming, to see how far apart these icons can get before there's a separation. So I need to find out where the separation line is so we can kind of customize it. But 80 times 80, like I said before, is the height for all of these icons here. Yeah, but basically you click on it and then you can click on any command over here in the profile and it'll be whatever it is here. And of course they have a couple of defaults too. Kind of lame, but it's good to know that you can create your own. So I definitely give this keyboard probably a 7 out of 10 just for kind of all this dumb shit, but overall it's a pretty great keyboard for the price tag. Probably not $300 worth, but I would say probably about, I think $250. $250 sounds about right, especially with the new Razer keyboard that's coming out, the black, or the death something, I'm not sure what it is, but all these new keyboards are coming out, are kind of jumping onto this macro interface. All right, so the last thing I'm going to show here is the back of the keyboard. You have two USB ports in the back. And this thing is actually a beast to put together. It comes with little bolts to bolt down all of the keyboard layout and design. However, you want it, you can always bolt it down. It is pretty sturdy by itself to not have to bolt it down, but it'd just be nice to bolt it down just for when you're moving it around or if you want to travel with it. You don't have to keep adjusting it, but just note that when you put it together without the bolts, it's pretty sturdy by itself. Another thing is that if you don't want this screen to be attached to the keyboard, no problem. You don't have to have it attached. It's attached by this metal kind of rod going into the keyboard. But the metal rod and this little kickstand that comes out with it, you could essentially, with these screws in the back, those two bolts, you can unscrew those and that metal rod will come out. But unfortunately, the kickstand comes out with it as well. But that allows you to attach that touchscreen wherever you want. Actually, it doesn't have to be on the keyboard, so you can attach it to like your monitor stand or kind of make your own mount for it on your table, so that way you can have your keyboard in one position and then the touchscreen in another position if you like. So that's pretty cool. The keyboard is powered by all these USB ports that are plugged into the back, and everything is metal, so the solid frame here, all that stuff is metal, so that's a huge plus as well. But overall, it's a great keyboard. If you can afford it, I would say it's, like I said before, it's probably not worth a $300 price tag. I would say $250 is probably the sweet spot for this keyboard, mainly because you're paying for the touchscreen interface. But other than that, this is a pretty cool looking beast.